Well, good morning, everybody in the Glenvale family. We're glad to have you here and welcome those of you that are watching us live on Facebook and YouTube. We're glad that you're joining us for this wonderful service that we're going to have today. We're here in the presence of God. We're here in the house of God with the family of God. And we're just excited to be able to sing, to pray, to worship, to spend our day in the presence of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Welcome, everybody, whether you're joining us online or whether you're here in the sanctuary, we welcome you to our service today, reminding you that there'll be another one at 6 o'clock tonight. So if you don't get full in the morning, come back and get stuffed in the afternoon with the presence of God. A couple of announcements I'd like to make, just things that you know that are going on this week. Our special guests this week, our family members that are all the way from Arkansas, Wisconsin, are here for the entire week with us, the Garms family. 6 o'clock tonight. Yep, I know a lot of you have been looking forward to this. They're here at 6 o'clock tonight, and then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday night, and you can come after work. You can come early. We have food downstairs in the fellowship hall. You can come and get a meal, eat something, and then come up here every night at 7 o'clock. And hear the Garms family sing and worship and praise God. And I heard him this morning, and like always, heavily anointed, voices are incredible, and Sam can even sing lower than he did last year. I was sitting back there on the pew, and it started vibrating when he hit the low note in that gospel song. I'm like, wow, the Spirit's moving. Flowers today. Given by Carolyn Robert Garlock in memory of Carolyn's dad, Ellis Bell. We thank you for that. Today is also the last Sunday. If any of you brought canned goods or anything, there's a box in the lobby for the Council of Churches as we're gathering together stuff for Thanksgiving to be able to bless some of the needy families in our area. Today is the last day you can put something in the box. If you didn't bring it this morning, then that's another reason to come back tonight, bring a canned good, and then hear the Garms family again. Congregational meeting coming up in 2 weeks, not this Wednesday, but the following Wednesday at 7 p.m. We invite everybody to come out and join us for that. This afternoon at 2:30, all the pastoral staff here will be traveling out to Bethel Independent Church. It's about 8 miles from here. There's a special Cemetery of the Innocent service for all those babies that were aborted. We're going to be going out there, and we're going to be praying and joining with other churches and just kind of thinking about the Lord and about those lives lost and just spending time out there. So we invite you all to go along with us for that if you'd like to. The more the merrier. Just think about coming with us. The last thing is that Wednesday, we're going to have the sweet hour prayer from 6 to 7 and then followed by the Garms at 7 o'clock. And so after you eat downstairs, come up and let's storm heaven and pray for God to really move and with all the different things that are going on. And that's just basically stuff that's going on this week. Let's take our hearts and turn it towards the Lord, right, in prayer. Father, first of all, as always, we praise you and worship you, Lord God. We thank you for everyone that's gathered here in your house. We thank you for the myriad that are watching us live on YouTube and Facebook right now. God, I pray that your Spirit will move in this place powerfully. And then that your Spirit will go through the airwaves to someone who's sitting on a couch watching on an iPad or sitting at a desk at a computer, Lord God, or maybe in front of a smart TV with their family or in one of the homes around here where people can't get out, Lord God. I pray for all those at Locust Village that are watching online that can't get out because they're on lockdown right now. Pray your blessing upon all those that are struggling with this COVID virus, Father. We have several people, Lord, either in the hospital or out of the hospital or dealing with issues, some have lost family members because of that disease, Father. We pray for all of them, Lord God. We pray for Skip Shoemaker especially, who's getting ready to have surgery on Wednesday for an aneurysm that took place in his aorta. That's the main valve into the heart, and there's some kind of leakage there. But God, you can heal that, Father. So we pray for him, Lord God. We lift him up to you and ask that you would touch him, Father. I pray you'll touch him in such a way that it'll blow the minds of the doctors and that he'd be able to say, God healed me. God healed me. We pray for Ava Johnston, who's in and out of the hospital, and she's been having difficulties ever since she had her COVID shot. She's in the military, Lord. I pray for her. I pray for Dalton, young man that I've been ministering to from Spain, who's in the United States Navy, is just going through a very difficult time, Lord. And I thank you for him. I thank you that he continues to reach out. I pray that you will bless him, Lord God, and help him through his tough time, Father, and be with him, Lord. We thank you that Cheryl Birkebaugh is out of the hospital. And even though she's in a rehab center down in the Shippensburg area, she's out of the hospital. Praise God for that, Lord. For those that have lost family members recently, we think of John Brownwell and his family who lost his mom on Thursday. We think of George Upgrove who passed away. We pray for peace and comfort for their families, Lord, and that you will be with them and just that will sense your presence filling them, surrounding them, and loving them through this difficult time. But God, we cannot end the prayer meeting unless we praise you and magnify you, because you answer so many prayers. So often we come to you, Father. We lift up needs, and again you answer prayer, and you just astound us by how faithful you are, even when we're not, Lord God. You're so faithful, and you're so precious to us, and we're so thankful for you, Lord God. And now we pray, Lord, that you will come into this meeting, take over this service, and move as you see fit, Father. This is your house. We are your people. And we praise your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, I could stand up here and drag this out a whole lot longer, but you didn't come here to see me, right? Thank you. Thank you. Keep it going. Oh, now you're embarrassing me. You didn't see that up there live, okay? Whether you're watching online or whether you're here in the sanctuary, strap in. We're going to get lost in God. We're going to worship. We're going to listen to some incredible singing. We're going to bless this family that has traveled from Arkansas and Wisconsin. Oh, right, they're both the same place. Arkansas, Wisconsin, and you didn't think that place existed, right? Somewhere out there is a schoolhouse full of Garms, and it's empty now because they're here. And we might let them leave on Thursday, but that's debatable. Just give your hands and just praise God and just welcome the Garms family as they come and sing and worship. Thank you, family, so much.
Never leave you or forsake you, and his word. all the time. You put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good all the time.
So unworthy, still for us He chose to die. He filled us with His Holy Spirit. Now we can stand and testify that His love is everlasting and His mercies, they will never end.
God is good all the time. You put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest nights, His light will shine. God is good.
Yes.
God is good all the time.
The word says so. It says God is good all the time, and we know by the testimony of other people. Well, we just happen to have a testimony song too, right?
Yes. All right.
Here you go. 1, 2, 3.
Working in town one afternoon, attending some business affairs. I heard a commotion a couple streets over. I wondered what's happening there. A young man was riding fun in that direction and stopped just to catch his breath. I asked him to please tell me what was the hurry. He smiled up at me and he said,
I was trying to catch the crippled man. Dead here I pass this way. He was rushing home to tell everyone what Jesus did today. And the mute man was telling myself and the deaf girl he's leaving to answer God's call. Oh, it's hard to believe, but if you don't trust me as the blind man, he saw it all. As the blind man, he saw it all.
Well, my friend, if the struggles, burdens you carry are heavy and dragging you down, you've tried everything you can possibly think of, and there's no relief to be found. That very same Jesus who altered the future of the blind man, the deaf and the lame, He's still reaching out in your hour of trouble. One touch and you're never the same. You'll be
to answer God's call.
Oh, it's hard to believe, but if you don't trust me
as the blind man, he saw it all.
Go ask the blind man,
he saw it all. You'll be trying to catch the crippled man, dead here on past this way.
He wasn't rushing home to tell everyone what Jesus did today.
And the mute man was telling myself and the deaf girl he's leaving to answer God's call.
Oh, it's hard to believe, but if you don't trust me,
for certain, we get to see it this morning as his presence is here. Hey, I'm just going to take a moment just to reacquaint us. Boy, many faces. It's good to see y'all again. I'll just tell you that. And new friends that we're meeting online. Wow. Just real quick, I'm curious. Anybody here seeing us for the first time this evening? This evening.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, okay. We'll just do quick introductions here. We are the Garms family from Arkansas, Wisconsin, and this is the umpteenth time we've been here.
Yeah.
And just because some of them are older, some of them sound different, some of them are larger, too, than they used to be. Taller, Caleb.
Yeah, I'm taller.
Yeah, say hi to Caleb.
Larger.
And Jamie.
Good morning.
And Sam.
Hello.
And Leisha.
Hey.
And Taylor.
Hello.
And Ben.
Howdy.
And she keeps looking younger and younger every time we're together. And so Chris is here in the back, yeah?
Hi, everyone. Yeah.
And of course.
And then my husband, David.
Yeah,
yes.
That too.
So,
it's going to be a wonderful weekend, not because of anything we've got planned, but the presence of God will be with us. Because where his word is, where two or three are gathered in his name, he is here. That's the promise. And we picked up this song. We didn't get to go to Florida this past year for some reason. But we picked up this song. We heard the Inspirations do this, the Dixie Echoes, and we're just going to have some. So it's Southern.
Oh.
So y'all from Arkansas, Wisconsin.
Oh, yeah.
You got to do some Southern singing for these people here. Okay, and we'll give you a little bluegrass sound behind you, and you sing Roll On.
One, two, three.
There's a river rolling deep and wide.
It's a golden
paradise is on the other side.
Yes, heaven is awaiting
when the soul life is o'er.
There will abide
forever.
So on, almighty old river to that sweet
forever.
Let your waves roll gently,
God.
Intently,
someday we must cross
your shore.
So roll on, Jordan, roll on,
roll on,
oh, dirty,
and wide.
My hope is on the other side. Gonna reach
to that
hope,
to carry you home.
So roll on, Jordan. Soon I know I'm going home.
I'm going there.
There I'll see my Savior on his throne.
Yes, there I'll see my Jesus.
I'll be so happy there.
Nevermore to roam.
No, nevermore to roam.
So roll, almighty old river,
to
that sweet
forever.
Let your waves roll gently,
God.
Your shores
intently.
Someday
we must cross
your shores.
So roll on, Jordan.
My home
is
he's on his the other side. Gonna reach that boat, Lord, so roll on, Jordan.
That's the river that a God has spanned. Reach that mansion in the promised land.
Roll on, roll on, Jordan.
Let him really go on.
Roll on, mighty river, to that forever. Let your wings roll gently, God. Intently, someday we must cross. So roll on, Jordan. Roll on, oh river deep and wide. My home is on the other side. Gonna reach that hope, Lord. So roll on, Jordan.
That's the river that a God has spanned to reach that mansion in the promised land.
Roll on, roll on, Jordan.
Been that long note that Pastor John was talking about right there. I'm not quite certain. That Jordan will roll on. And Christ gives us the opportunity to roll right on over it into heaven with him. But in the meantime, we're still on this planet and on this earth, and God's going to give us encouragement so that we can walk this life and we can still be trusting in him.
I've seen the righteous man suffer pain, and it looked like the wicked would go free. And in my frustration, that just didn't seem right to me. I asked you sunshine, and you sent the rain. I cried for healing, and I only got pain. But I know that your love will see me through. Lord, I still trust you. I still trust you, Lord. I still trust you, Lord, that you're able to guide me through this dry barren. You, Lord, His dry barren land. And when I don't know which way to turn or go, I still trust you.
Can we trust God? How? Well, listen to this little bit here. Romans 15 says, for whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that through endurance and through the encouragement of the scriptures we might have hope. How do we have that hope? Because Jesus has been there, done that. Do we have trials? Sure we do. Every one of us, we all have come into this room, this sanctuary, with those trials today. Jesus had them. He certainly did. It's in the Word. He had difficulties, persecution, trials. Jesus even died. He's been there, done that. He even was put in the cold grave. He's done that too. And he knows what it's like to rise from the dead and go to heaven, so that he can give us that encouragement and hope through his Word, that we might not face this life alone, that we've had, it's all there, his love and his care and his experience. It's for us, because there's hope, hope beyond the cross.
Jesus once died for me, and I asked, is this a place where hope abides? And this he said to me, tomb that is empty, you won't find me there anymore. And beyond the tomb is life everlasting and hope forever. Assurance, and I went to the tomb, oh, to the place where his body once lay. And I cried, Lord, help me see, is there hope here for me? Empty, you
As we have done in the past, our family brings the word in song and a few moments that I have to bring the word in spoken word. Like I said earlier this morning, this is the part I pray for the revival throughout the year, but this is the part that I pray the most because it gives me the most anxiety. But because I approach it that I don't think and I don't plan that I can do anything to get anything across to you. It is my prayer that God does through his word. And my job is just to share it a little bit with all y'all. So that's what we're going to do this week of revival. What I've done was I've pulled some of the songs this year that have meant an awful lot to our family. I want to share about those songs. Sometimes I'll share a little bit of those songs because they mean so much. We pick our songs carefully because and not every song out there do we want to sing because we don't think they teach the right thing. We want to be able to draw directly from God's word and say, yeah, although a song might be deep or it might be shallow, it's going to come from God's word, and we can point you right there. So that's what we're going to do this week. This morning, I came across this verse that kind of sets the attitude, for me anyway, for revival. From Lamentations 3, it says, "Let us examine our ways and test them, and let us return to the Lord." A time of refreshment, of encouragement and hope. And I certainly hope that you might have an opportunity, that God might give you a chance to say to somebody else this week, come with me tonight. Let's spend some time together with the Lord in his word and in his song. And that according to his blessing, it will be a blessing for everybody that comes. So invite somebody to come along as we hear the word. Our first song this morning, to him actually, The Love of God. I really like it. Not only the words, but where it comes from, where I think it comes from in the Bible, and that's Psalm 103. So I just want to take a few moments this morning and unpack that just for you, and that we might share in that. And I want to read for you just a few verses from Psalm 103, starting at verse 8, where it says, "The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in love. He will not always accuse, nor will he harbor his anger forever. He does not treat us as our sins deserve, or repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. For he knows how we are formed. He remembers we are dust. But from everlasting to everlasting, the Lord's love is with those who fear him." Yeah, that's the word. And I encourage you that as you have opportunity today, get a Bible out, go to Psalm 103, read the whole thing. As it talks about God's love and the relationship that we have with him. You see, the Bible, by and large, was written to people who are in relationship with God. As New Testament people, those of us who know Christ as their Lord and Savior from sin, death, and the power of the devil, that he has redeemed us by his blood on the cross, and we believe that, we are in relationship with God. The Bible's written to us. In the Old Testament, it was the people of Israel who were living under the covenant of the same God who were looking forward to a Savior to come. That Old Testament was written to them, and there's tons of gospel throughout the Old Testament. And we're looking at the love of God here that we have in Psalm 103. How much does God love us? That psalm talks about as high as the heavens and from everlasting to everlasting. Now, 2 years ago, we were still from Braham, Minnesota. And there, while we were here, and Pastor Vicki called it, didn't she? She said, you're going to get somebody who's going to buy your house. And while we were here, we signed the contract, email-wise, we signed the contract for the sale of our house so we could move to Arkansas, Wisconsin. That was pretty cool. One neat thing about nearby Durand, Wisconsin, the county seat, it has a great thrift store. It does. Chris loves it. She found at the thrift store this huge book called Cosmos, and it's full of photographs from the Hubble telescope and other telescopes that can look out light years, thousands of light years, and see the wonders of what God has made. They're fantastic. I don't like reading the text because it talks about things I don't believe. We'll go into that tonight, by the way. But anyway, but it has beautiful pictures. And that far out, that distance out that we can't travel to but we can see is a reminder from God's word of how much he loves us. And I have a little problems wrapping my brain around that. But there's more that I understand. When God talks about how he does not repay us as our sins deserve or repay according to our iniquities, one thing that we can do when we come into the sanctuary of God, it's okay to look at his word and admit to ourselves we sin. We fall short of God's glory. And admit that we are shamed by that. And we might be carrying some guilt. Because here in the sanctuary, we get to hear about how God has forgiven us for Christ's sake. All those sins. That's how great. How can God love me? If y'all know what I know about myself inside me, or if y'all would know some of the things Chris knows about me, maybe you wouldn't forgive me. But God does. That's how much he loves us. It's hard to paint the picture unless we've had those experiences in life, which if we know Christ, we know our sin, and we've had the experience. But we go to the word and we learn more of how he's loved others, and he still loves us so abundantly. One thing that God is not, however, God's love is not tolerance. It isn't that he puts up with our sin. To be honest, he doesn't want us to sin at all. But he's done something about it to forgive us our sins. What a great relationship. Just like a father loves his children and will take time to say, no, don't go this way. No, don't touch the hot stove. It's going to burn you. You're going to get hurt. Our compassionate, loving Father loves us that much that he can be in that kind of relationship with us. Things to ponder as we walk in a repentance and faith with our loving Heavenly Father. So what do we get to do? Now that we know this love, and we, in our lives, get an idea of how great it is, we get to share it with others. It goes on because it could be the person right next to you, or it could be someone that you run into outside of these walls that needs to hear it. Psalm 89 says these words, I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. I declare that your love stands firm forever, that you established your faithfulness in heaven itself. Hey, we're back to the heavens. And how God uses the imagery to try to convey his love. So, today, tonight, tomorrow, as you have opportunity, as that love of God impacts you, tell somebody else. Let them know. Or invite them to come. And we'll work as a team. And we'll let them know. And somebody online can tell somebody else, hey, come hear about the love of God. Yeah. So I'm going to have family come back up here. And now we're going to share with you that song, The Love of God. Listen for the depths, the riches, the care. Why? Just listen for the love of our God.
Forevermore endure the
the love of God. Aren't you glad that he loves you?
Yes.
We are truly a blessed people because the creator of all heaven and earth loves us so much that he sent his son to die on a cross.
Amen.
Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
We are truly blessed also with the fact that the Garms family is here, right? Yeah. They're home. They're back.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Yes.
Well, as Pastor John said, we might let them go. We'll see what happens. We're going to keep them here as long as we can, though. Actually, I want to try to get them up on the mountain sometime this week so they can see, because they haven't been, they have not been up there since we have finished our home, or got close to finishing our home. Anyway, I need to stop right where I'm at right now because we don't have a lot of time. But I want you to know that we do need to take care of their needs while they're here. We have been very generous, in my estimation, over the past many years that they've been coming, and I want to see it even grow more this year. And I forget how much it was 2 years ago, but I know it was several thousand dollars. And I also know from traveling and being on the road for years myself that it's very expensive, especially where fuel costs are right now. How big is the tank in that bus?
220 gallons.
And how many miles do you get to the gallon?
Anywhere from three to nine.
You can do the math.
Yeah.
And they also have to eat. With a growing family, that might be more expensive than the fuel. And of course, for those of you that don't know, they purchased a school that they're living in and making it into a venue for concerts and being able to do, they live stream when they're not on the road, they're live streaming from there. And so there's many things that the God is doing through them. And of course, they're supported by God's people. So though we're not receiving a formal offering right now, there is a box right beside our tithe and offering box specifically for the Garms family. And if you want to write a check, write it out to the Garms. And as I said earlier this morning, just whatever number you put in there, put plenty of zeros past that. We'll reach our goal pretty quickly. There are some people that can afford to do that. Some of us can't. But we do what we can. And God bless us. For those of you that are watching online, you can go to the Glenvale website, gvcog.com, and you'll see a blue rectangle there, and you can click on that. If you can, well, they actually can't see the screen because I don't have that up there. But you can go there, and or you can go to the Garms family's website, which is, what is it?
TheGarmsFamily.com.
Now imagine something like that. You can go there and donate also. So let's pray over the offering, and we will continue. Precious Lord, we are so thankful. We are being blessed today, and we will be blessed this week. And I thank you, Father, for those that are volunteering to do the food and all of the things that we put together for this week. We want to make it easy for people to come. They can come straight from work, come here, have their supper, and be able to enjoy the music and the word of God every night this week up until Thursday night. Lord, I pray that you would bring them in from the east, the north, the south, and the west. I pray, Lord, that you would reach thousands of people via the social media portals that we use. And Lord, we pray that we will be able to bless this family as they leave here, that they can not only say it's good to be in the house of the Lord, but they can also say it was good to be home in Glenvale. The Lord, we praise you ahead of time. We're looking for a miracle this week because our numbers are down because of COVID. But Father, you are able to supply all of our need according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. And so we just lay it at your precious feet and thank you, Father.
In his name we pray. Amen.
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 We've got one more song that we're going to enjoy, and y'all going to sing with us on that one more song. All y'all. Yeah, Ewan's. Ewan's going to. That's right. I got to get in the right state here. So we're not going to say much about the table here. Come back tonight. We'll say more about it. But I'm going to say this. We've got something new, and it's called the Part of the Family T-shirts. Especially if you're a part of the family of God, more than part of the family of the Garms family. But we have those, and I say it already now, because Tuesday evening is T-shirt night. And if you are so inclined and want to obtain one of these, they're there at the table. We're going to wear it. You know, we're not going to wear the suits.
No.
Yeah.
At least the guys aren't. We're wearing our T-shirts. So it's T-shirt part of the family night. So we just wanted to tell you that here.
It'll look like a pumpkin patch.
Yeah. Yeah. There it is.
Bunch of pumpkins. Yeah.
So anyway, one more song is, no, not quite yet, because I do want to say thank you. I can't express the gratitude that we have, because different ones of you have been so kind over this past year and a half, be coming up on 2 years soon, of this amazing God supporting us through you. Through some of you didn't know that you're part of a team that around this country that have sustained us so that we can continue to do this full time as a family. But our family says thank you. So with that, let's sing Victory in Jesus.
Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood's atoning, and I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me and I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Streets of gold beyond the crystal sea, about the angels singing and the old redemption story, and some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me and I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath.
tonight. We got lots of them.
So you can get more than one more, you just got back for it. So who all plans on being here tonight? How about the rest of the week? Good. I'll be here every night but Tuesday. Which, did I miss it? Did you announce the Tuesday night?
Yeah.
Okay. I must have been on the way down the steps. I spent the day with Pastor Larry yesterday. That's all I'm going to say. Well, thank you, everyone, for coming. And once again, let's give the Garms one more round of applause for now. Thank you guys so much for blessing us. It is definitely a blessing. And just want to remind everyone again, tonight at 6, and then the rest of the week, 5:30 for a meal. And if you want to bring something extra, bring something extra. You know it'll get eaten. And then 7 o'clock, we'll be blessed again. So with that, we're going to close in prayer. Kind and most gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you now so overjoyed and blessed and humbled at the same time. Just thank you so much for this extreme blessing that you have given to us, and that the Garms can be home again. Unfortunately, they're going to have to leave again, but just like the prodigal son, they're going to come back again. I just pray that you will bless everyone that's here today and bless everyone that's watching via the internet, and just pray that you will bless everyone as they leave here today. Give them a good rest of the day, give them a safe time, and bring us all back again later on tonight for one more song at least. We pray this in the holy and precious name of your only begotten Son, Jesus. Amen. Oh, we don't have the lights on. Well, pretend we're out in the lights. Be blessed and see everyone tonight. Thank you.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good. Oh, 2:30 at here. Bethel Independent Church, 2:30. The celebration for the babies that were aborted in Perry County.